Ever gone on a treasure hunt? I can remember as a child looking for treasure on the beach. Each pretty shell or piece of sea glass became treasure which was taken home and put in my treasure box. Last year we bought my great nephew, who was 6 at the time, a metal detector for Christmas so that he could go looking for his own treasure. There are so many TV programs following people hoping to find treasure, whether it's digging for gold or hoping that a discarded antique in the loft might be worth millions. People play the lottery in desperate hope of winning treasure that will last a lifetime. As I grew up, my treasures changed. The lovingly collected items in my box were thrown out, and my treasure became a favourite record, photos, posters. If you were to go and do a treasure hunt around your house, I wonder what you'd come up with. These trainers that I keep in my wardrobe were given to me by a church member many years ago. I was told they belonged to Robbie Williams, who had left them when he moved out of a flat, and they would be worth lots of money. But without proof, they're simply old red Puma trainers. Though if Robbie Williams is watching and these are your trainers, do let me know, for they'd raise a lot of money for the church. In my jewellery box, I keep this eternity ring that my dad bought for my mum when I was born. When my mum died, my dad gave it to me. It's not particularly valuable in a monetary sense, but it has special meaning to me. Like my wedding ring, which I never take off. When we got engaged, Steve wanted to buy me a new wedding ring, but I knew exactly what I wanted. Just before we got together, Steve's grandmother had died, and Steve, as our only surviving relative, had inherited her wedding ring. She'd been widowed as a young mum when her husband had died following an accident while working on the railway. She was 96 when she died, and she'd never taken the ring off. Her heart had always belonged to the young man who had given her this ring, a symbol of lifelong love. But are these really my treasures? If the house caught fire, what would I rescue? My possessions? No, my husband and my cat. No possessions mean that much to me. There isn't anything I would risk going into a burning building for. My treasures are those I love. Jesus said in Luke's Gospel, "For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." For many people, their treasure is money locked away in a bank. Their heart is equally locked away, unable to be free. Their love of money and possessions becomes an obsession. There's an old German proverb that says, "Money is like seawater. The more we drink, the thirstier we become." Whatever our treasure, money, jewels, antiques, art, we'll never have enough. The more we have, the more we desire. We're never truly happy or satisfied. If money and possessions are our treasures, then our hearts are earthbound, as they remain where our treasure is. The greatest treasure in my life, no one can take away from me, because it's my relationship with God. That's where my heart lies. It's more precious than anything else, anything that this world could ever give me. It's a very costly treasure, but I didn't purchase it. Jesus did. It cost him his very life, and he gave this treasure to me as a free gift. This treasure I'll have with me every day of this life, and I'll take with me into eternity. Jesus said, "Don't store up treasure on earth where it can be stolen or will rot and decay, but store up treasure in heaven, a treasure chest of good deeds, of a loving life and a deep faith in God." Next time you think about going on a treasure hunt, don't go hunting through your cupboards or out on the beach with a metal detector, but hunt through the Bible for verses that are true gems that will build up your faith and strengthen you each day. These treasures will last for a lifetime and beyond. Get your priorities right. Seek to know Jesus Christ and have God's life-giving Holy Spirit in your heart. All other treasure is dross, worthless compared to this. I want to finish with Philippians 3:8, which says, "Yes, everything else is worthless when compared to the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I've discarded everything else, counting it all as garbage, so that I could gain Christ." So let us pray. Father, we thank you for the true treasure of knowing your love for ourselves and knowing Jesus to be our Lord and Saviour. Help us not to hold on to the riches of this world, but seek the riches of your kingdom. We bring these prayers in the priceless name of Jesus. Amen.
Upon all this world revealed. knowing you, Jesus, knowing you, there is.